A vile god, powerful, so large.
The film begins the planet of the Maximals, where the twisted transformer god Unicron is planning to make his drop and consume the planet for power.
But he wanted our greatest technology, Transwarp Key, and he sent his Scourge.
Unicron sends his minions, the Terrorcons, led by Scourge, to retrieve for him the Transwarp Key, which would enable Unicron to get to limitless universes to consume. The Maximals Apolink, Primal, Eraser, Rhinox, and Cheetor set up their leave from the planet, but Apolink stays behind to fight while bestowing Primal with the name Optimus Primal.
What will you do?
Go! Use it to escape!
This is my fight. I'll hold him off. It's now your time to lead the Maximals.
Scourge shows up and fights Apolink alongside his freezer drones. While Apolink demolishes the freezers, Scourge mortally wounds Apolink but realizes too late that the Maximals have already escaped with the key.
They never learn.
You're too late, Scourge.
No.
Unicron then continues to gobble up the planet.
Cap 2 for 5's over here, baby.
Then movie shows Brooklyn in 1994. Former soldier electronics expert Noah Diaz lives with his mom Brianna and younger brother Chris. Chris suffers from a disorder, and the family is struggling to bring in cash for his medical treatment.
Oh, hell no. My dog.
It's my own personal way to protest the vampiric nature.
At the point when Noah saw his brother's disorder getting most terrible, Noah goes to the hospital and but unfortunately has no insurance for his brother to get help.
He's 11 years old.
While on that, he goes in for a job interview. He is told by the director of the organization that he has dropped the interview in the wake of addressing Noah's previous superior, who says he is bold yet can't work in a team.
It's me, Noah Diaz. He said our interview is canceled.
Why?
Your own commanding officer called me back. Said you were couldn't trust you, unreliable.
I know you don't know how to be part of a team.
Listen, I can't have someone like you.
Elena Wallace works as an intern for a snooty gallery owner named called Jillian. Criminal investigators are at work on the grounds that art gallery chief got busted and might have been keeping fakes. Elena confirms for Jillian what is authentic and what is fake, but Jillian takes credit for the findings.
Real ones at the National Gallery
vase. Elena then finds a statuette looking like Eraser, complete with the Transformers badge carved onto it.
Now where did you come from? Symbol is definitely not hieroglyphic.
Jillian believes it's ancient Sumerian, but Elena does her research. While on, Noah goes to his friend Reek, who convinces him to steal a Porsche car being kept in the carport of another organization so he can sell it. Noah figures out how to sneak in and tracks down the Porsche, breaking into it.
Yeah, whatever. I
hey, whatever is divine.
Your friends?
Kids.
It's
like at the same time, Elena secretly getting into the lab and utilize a device to look further into the statuette, but ends up breaking it and finding a one part of the Transwarp Key inside. This conveys a sign that stirs the Autobots, and Optimus Prime calls upon Bumblebee, RC, and Mirage, the latter being the car that Noah is currently inside.
Away home. This cannot be.
Calling all Autobots!
This is RC. I have a visual.
Calling all Autobots.
A security guard catches Noah, which Mirage to start driving himself out of the car park. A police pursuit across the city results, where Noah understands the vehicle is driving itself.
What you doing?
Exercises the car's driving by itself.
Just leave me.
And a 1037 in progress, silver Porsche.
As the police draw nearer, Mirage demonstrates his powers by creating illusions of himself to distract the cops, allowing him and Noah to move away. Mirage carries Noah to a place where he transforms into his Autobot form, which monstrosities Noah out.
But that was fun, man. You're fun, dude. Tough guy. I'm an alien. Like, the name's Mirage.
Optimus and RC are none excessively satisfied to track down a human among them. Yet B is seriously trusting, and Mirage thinks Noah is fine.
Mirage.
You brought a human here?
He's already in the car, but he's cool, so it's cool.
Who are you?
Optimus makes reference to that the key has conveyed a sign and that they need to pursue it so they can get back to Cybertron.
I cannot believe it. The Transwarp Key. We finally found a way home.
It's in the new museum on Ellis Island. What we need is a quiet way in.
He's perfect. He could slip in right through one of them little doors.
No, it is a bad idea.
You help us get this key so we can get off this rock. What about for Cat? Ah, got him! He's in, baby!
After Mirage convinced to Optimus Prime, Noah joins Mirage as they advance to the art gallery to get the key. However, Scourge and his Terrorcon cronies, Battletrap and Nightbird, are now on the Earth and are pursuing the key too.
Finally, the hunt.
Noah enters the museum hall and alarms Elena, who believes he's an intruder. After a battle, Noah attempts to make explain of that he wants the key, which Elena actually doesn't realize what is the thing she's holding. And Elena possibly accepts him when Scourge shoots an opening through the wall and kills a security guard.
Don't move!
Man is back.
But those ones are with me.
Bring me the key.
It's yours.
As the Terrorcons endeavor to assault, the Autobots appear for the battle to come.
Guys, we got company!
Autobots! Protect the key!
While Optimus and Bumblebee attempt to pursue Scourge, the deadly Terrorcon impales Bumblebee and shoots him in the chest, killing him while Optimus can watch with sickening dread. Before Scourge can take Optimus too, Airazor flies in and drives Scourge and the others away. However, though he has taken the key with him.
Call yourself a Prime. Primus would be ashamed. Me!
Scourge gets back to Unicron and finds that it's just half of the key, which makes the god violently punish his Scourge.
You fool! This is only half the key.
Airazor clears up the situation for the Autobots, in addition to Noah and Elena, and Elena verifies that the other part of the key should be in Peru, based on the readings she looked up.
It's in Peru.
The Inca Temple of the Sun in Cusco.
Elena. Will you lead us to this temple?
Prior to leaving, Noah gets back to see Chris, however Mirage appears and makes his presence obvious. Noah clarifies his main goal for Chris and advises Mirage to promise to keep his brother safe.
You know this thing?
Yeah, that's why I have to leave.
Hey, robot. Watch out for my brother.
Noah's back, I promise.
Mountain?
I'm walking to Peru.
To go to Peru, the group goes inside Stratosphere, an Autobot that transforms into a ramshackle old plane. On the way, Noah tells Elena that they should destroy the key to prevent Unicron's arrival, even if it means the Autobots will be stuck on Earth. When they land to the Peru, they meet with a local Autobot named Wheeljack who guides them to their area. Mirage also gives Noah a gadget that wraps around his wrist in case he needs to defend himself.
Me and Elena will do it.
It is not a bad idea.
Yo, Noah, think fast. And if you need help, just holler.
But it's not lined up right.
Noah and Elena enter an underground cave after finding Transformers symbols and make their way down. Unfortunately, the Terrorcons have shown up also, and Scourge sends more freezers to pursue Noah and Elena. The two find a crypt where the key should be, however find it empty except for some inscriptions that Elena gets on paper.
I think we found what we came here for.
See these symbols? I've seen markings like this. They're not on the Transwarp Key.
There's two of them.
At the point when they are spotted, they make a run for it, and the Autobots follow.
I'm on the way!
Eraser, where are the humans?
The underground, heading towards the jungle.
Aw, man, they're tailing us!
During the pursuit, Optimus promises revenge for Bumblebee by attempting to pursue Scourge, while the others take on Battletrap and Nightbird.
This is for B!
Eraser joins the battle, however she gets set apart by Scourge with one of his devices. The others scarcely escape. Noah and Elena leave the caves and end up in a jungle where they are stood up to by Primal and the other Maximals. The Autobots appear at shield the people until Eraser tells Primal that they are partners.
Stop! Prime, these are my fellow Maximals.
I'm happy to see you, old friend. Come with me.
Primal lets the others know that he and the Maximals shift the other key half away to protect it. The Maximals guide everybody to a close-by village that they secure and impart a partnership to the people that live there, as they are the ones keeping the other key half safe.
Your friend will find peace here.
This is raw energon. Could this revive be?
Later, Primal shows Optimus raw energon that can be utilized to give live to be. However, it requires a huge surge of energy. In the meantime, Elena tells Noah perhaps they shouldn't destroy the key as they discussed and thinks about him to Optimus, as they are both big brothers paying special attention to their families.
Eraser?
Toward the beginning of the day, Eraser has become completely adulterated by the dark energy that Scourge contaminated her with.
They found us, Noah. Guard the key.
Get out of here!
Primal instruct to Noah and Elena to run with key, and while that Noah also seizes an opportunity to destroy the key with the wrist device given by the Mirage. However, Optimus begs him not to do as such until he relents. Unfortunately, this gives Scourge a chance to hold onto the key and advance back to Unicron.
No! Wait, wait. We'll see about that. Kill them.
She starts to assault and make signal to the Scourge until the other Maximals attempt to control her. Primal attempts to hold her down, but Eraser tells him to do what he has to do, so he squeezes her until she breaks down and dies.
It's okay. Do it. Scourge has the key.
Unicron, your time has come.
Scourge and the Terrorcons combine the two parts of the key together and create a platform over a volcano to summon Unicron. After Optimus and Noah understand their actions have worsened the situation, the Autobots and Maximals, and Noah and Elena combine efforts to stop the villains for the last time.
Noah and Elena reach the central antenna.
Move the Transwarp Key. They can use the code to shut it down and close the portal before Unicron enters our atmosphere.
Wait, I got it. The one
had... Elena uses the markings she found to come up with a code that can disable the key.
Scourge, they're back.
Prime.
The heroes then charge into battle, with Basic telling Rhinox and Cheetor to transform into their Transformers bodies to battle against the incoming horde of Scorponokes.
Rhino, Cheetor, Maximi!
Mirage assists Noah and Elena with finding a passage to get up to the main controlling point to enter the code. Optimus and Primal then team up with Rip Battletrap apart before Primal crushes his head with his own wrecking ball.
And give me a real fight! It's a fight you want?
You got one.
We're too late.
This world is already mine.
Unicron begins getting nearer to Earth, with his presence reaching other cities like back in New York.
What do we have here? Brave.
When Noah gets closer, Scourge attempts to kill him, but Mirage uses his body to shield Noah before he is also killed.
Come on, you gotta get up!
It's okay, Noah.
You shown it.
Chris!
However, Mirage is able to transfer part of his body to the wrist device to create a suit for Noah to utilize in battle after encouraging Chris talking to him over Mirage's radio.
Apartment 2C, Brooklyn, New York.
No names over the airwaves.
Yo, Scourge! Remember me?
He is not alone.
No!
Energon.
The energy waves from the key also managed to charge the Energon, bringing B back to life. B enters the battle and proceeds to help turn things around, including him flying out of sight with Nightbird and destroying her.
Glad to have you back.
It's dead!
Elena, shut it down!
We gotta give her some cover!
Optimus fights Scourge, almost winning until Scourge impacts the main controller being utilized for Elena to enter the key, delivering it pointless.
Just you and me, Scourge! Away! Let's end this once.
Rap and they all on throw on the mama paper box. It's about to go.
God, it's about to go.
We gotta hurry! Ugly mother!
Make this world!
You did it!
Prevail!
Later!
Optimus dismembers Scourge before ripping his head off and then resolving to destroy the key himself to prevent Unicron from getting closer.
I will destroy the key myself.
There's gotta be another way.
Your sacrifice becomes our oath.
We can't leave him!
Don't prime, then die!
The key explodes, causing a vortex that sends Unicron away yet almost pulls Optimus with it until Primal and Noah assist with pulling him back.
I got you!
Noah! Let me go, Noah!
While Unicron may still be out there, the Autobots and Maximals recognize their triumph and head out in different directions. Noah and Elena fly home, and he gets back to Chris and their mom. Later on, Noah is up for another new employee interview. He meets a man named Agent Burke, who realizes about Noah being in Peru and working with the Autobots. However, Noah attempts to deny it.
We are a secret government organization.
Burke offers Noah an opportunity to join a mysterious government association, in any event, ensuring that Chris' clinical costs will be covered.
Save the world, kid.
Noah is unbelievably grateful and looks as Burke goes into a mystery room loaded up with vehicles, devices, and other top-secret things. Noah then looks at Burke's business card and learns the name of the organization, G.I. Joe.
G.I. Joe.
This is a complete waste of yes.
After all, during the movie credits, Noah is with Reek as he is repairing Mirage. Reek believes it's pointless until Noah calls upon Mirage to turn on, and the Autobot reawakens proudly.